Hi, my name is Jens Lohne Eftang, and I'm a technical lead for Sesam workflows for floating offshore wind. As offshore structures become more complex, the computational models also become larger, and that leads to more expensive analyses. Therefore, choosing the right methodology for the design phase is critical, and the key is to minimize computational cost while maintaining the required accuracy. And this is a challenge also for floating offshore wind substructures. In Sesam, we have worked closely with partners and customers to provide new solutions to this challenge. The frequency domain uncoupled method is the quickest method available in Sesam. It can be used typically for initial sizing, for early design, or for prototype phases. The method consists of a hydrodynamic and finite element analysis of the wave-induced structure response for specified wave directions and wave frequencies. The method accounts for moorings, and it includes the wind turbine, represented simply as a point mass. The loads typically come directly from the wind turbine manufacturer as damage equivalent loads for fatigue analysis or FLS, or as extreme loads for ultimate limit state analysis or ULS. The method is very fast, but it also has some limitations and assumptions that needs to be considered. Sesam also offers three time domain workflows, which in different ways balance performance and accuracy. In general, a time domain method is more accurate than a frequency domain method because it considers the simultaneous effects of the wind and the wave loading. The starting point for all of these methods is a coupled analysis using a tool such as SEMA or bladed. The time domain direct load generation method is the most general method available. In this method, the hydrodynamic pressure and the Morrison loads are generated directly in the time domain before being mapped to a finite element structure. The finite element analysis is then performed, followed by FLS or ULS post-processing. This method allows you to explore nonlinear hydrodynamic effects and the importance of dynamic local structure response. We think that this method typically will serve as a baseline for determining whether or not one of the faster methods can be used. The time domain load reconstruction method is a faster time domain method. In this method, instead of directly computing the hydrodynamic pressure in the time domain, which is expensive, the pressure is reconstructed using the results from the coupled analysis combined with pre-computed pressure components associated with unit waves and unit motions, which accounts for the diffracted and radiated hydrodynamic pressure. This pre-computation is done only once, and the data is reused for all subsequent design load cases. The method allows for dynamic or quasi-static local structure response, but non-linear hydrodynamic effects cannot be included. And finally, we have the time domain response reconstruction method. This is the fastest time domain method available. And in this method, the local quasi-static structure response is reconstructed using the coupled analysis results combined with pre-computed responses associated with unit waves and motions accounting for the hydrodynamic pressure and unit loads accounting for inertia, mooring, tower, and Morrison loads. Again, this pre-computation is done only one time, and the data is reused for all design load cases. This means that for a new design load case, no load generation is performed, and there is no separate finite element analysis. This results in a method which is orders of magnitude faster than a standard time domain approach. And in practice, it may reduce the simulation time from hours to just a few minutes for one design load case. If you are interested in this or any of the other new methods available in Sesam, please visit our webpages.